Well, we all know what the five senses are: taste, touch, sight, hearing and smelling. Do we know the seven? Well, the sixth is known as the vestibular sense, so that's a sense of balance. And the seventh is proprioception, which is the sense of where our body is in space. So if I'm closing my eyes and I've got my hand up, I can work out where each muscle and joint is. And if I want to touch my left ear, I can do that straight away without making a mistake, or touch my right shoulder, for instance. So that's the seventh sense, proprioception. Then there's a lesser known sense, which is known as interoception, which is the sensation of how the body is inside, but also how to feel and interpret emotions. So, for instance, it's the interoception sense that will let us know that we're hungry or tired or need to open our bowels, go to the toilet, if we're full up, if we're dehydrated and need to drink something, if we're tired. And then also how we feel frustrated or angry, sad, excited, embarrassed. And these are all from physical sensations. So the interoceptor send signals up to the brain, which can interpret how the body is inside and also how we are feeling emotionally, and helps us to regulate our body by eating or passing urine or having a rest if we're tired, and also our emotions as well. So we know if we're feeling anxious and need to take slow breaths to feel more calm. Now, children with certain neurodevelopmental disorders, such as autism, may have a difficulty with regulation of emotions, but also of physical functions. So, for instance, if they are hypersensitive to interoceptive input and do not like the physical sensations, they may, for instance, go to the toilet to pass urine more often because they don't like the feeling inside of needing to go to the toilet, or they may not like the feeling of hunger, so they may eat more than other children. They may conversely crave the sensations, sensory seekers. So a child might not eat or drink as often as other children because they like the sensation of feeling hungry or thirsty, or they might run a lot because they like the sensation of feeling out of breath. Then there are other children who just don't feel the interoceptive input so much, or are unable to interpret it. So they don't know that they need to pass urine because they can't feel it physically, and therefore might wet the bed at night or take longer to be dry by day, or not actually achieve that. And they may not know that they're hungry, so may not eat as much, or may not know that they're thirsty or need to open their bowels. And as these children, or adults even, do not feel the physical sensations and able to interpret emotions, they may not know, for instance, that they're angry or frustrated, and therefore, once it all builds up, they suddenly have a meltdown and weren't aware of how upset or tense they had been feeling. Or, for instance, they may not feel the physical sensation of anxiety, and may therefore not feel fear, and may not be able to keep themselves out of danger. Thank you for listening. I hope this video has been interesting and informative for you. Please remember to like and subscribe, and I'll see you soon. Bye for now.